I just roasted you these chestnuts on an open fire, and boy are they tasty. Did you know chestnuts are actually a starch? A whole healthy starch. They're not a nut at all. So we're gonna make them into a bake. A loaf? Bake. We're gonna bake them into a loaf. Here we bake. Hey everybody, this is Dylan. Christmas is right around the corner, and that means you need some healthy plant-based recipes to make your feast a huge success. Well, you're in luck. We've got one for you today. It is our Christmas Chestnut Bake, we call it. Of course, you can enjoy this all year round because no, I didn't roast my own chestnuts. I got them right out of the bag. Every time I have tried to roast my own chestnuts, I swear, it does not work. I think that they made up the whole song. You can buy them pre-roasted and peeled, all ready to go in a bag. This only cost me $3 at our Asian market. If you don't have an Asian market with these, you might have to buy them online, spend a little bit more dollars, you know what I mean? All right, everybody, let's get to cooking. This is a simple recipe. There are a few extra steps compared to like my normal really, really simple recipes, but don't get discouraged. It's well within your means here. And by the way, you can make this a day in advance and then just leave it in the fridge and then throw it in the oven on the day of. Save time and you can relax a little more on your holiday. How's that sound? Let's do this thing. The first thing we gotta do is make some flax egg to be our binder on this loaf, and to do that we're just going to grind up some flax seeds if you don't have them ground already, and then add a little water, stir it up, and just let it sit. We'll come back to that later in the recipe. Yes, this is a winter recipe, so we do need some butternut squash in there, you know what I mean? You could take a whole butternut squash and chop it in half and roast it in the oven if you want to, or you can do what I do, the easy way, and I just buy a bag of prepared butternut squash, but it's not cooked and I need to steam it because we're gonna mash it. So all I'm gonna do is throw it into the steamer pot like that, and we'll just let it sit for a few minutes to steam, and then it'll be really easy to mash after that, you know what I mean? Let's get back to do some chopping, how about it?
Oh my gourd, that's easy.
Oh my gourd.
You're in the wrong season, Bill.
This is a winter shirt. The leaves are on the ground. Let's get to chopping up that fall harvest. We're gonna start with a couple of carrots. Just chop them pretty small. They don't have, you know, don't have to be that perfect. Next, we'll chop up a couple stalks of celery, same as the carrots, no big deal. Then on to a yellow onion, dice it up and throw it in. And then I've got a handful of mushrooms. They could be the white or the brown mushrooms. It doesn't matter. Chop them up, throw them in. Since you're at the cutting board, you might as well prep your garlic, chop it up, mince it up real nice and small, and we'll use that in a little bit too. All right, y'all, it is time to saute. I've just got this on a nice high heat, and then as it gets a little sticky, I'm just adding a little bit of veggie stock. This is a new one I found that has no added salt and there's no oil in it, so that's cool. Oftentimes I just use water for this, I'm not gonna lie. But in the wintertime, I do like to use a little veggie stock because it gives it that nice, rich, all those fall, wintry flavors. So just give it a stir. As things start to dry out, add a little veggie stock until everything's nice and tender. My favorite thing in the world
is
sauteing a mirepoix with mushrooms. I'm just gonna keep adding a little bit of veggie stock as I need it. Just do it in a little, few little sessions, you know what I mean? Maybe it takes 3-4 times and then everything's nice and tender. And then we'll add our spices. Here's what we've got, a little dried sage, rosemary, and thyme. I'm gonna throw that on top and then add a little bit of veggie stock because it's starting to get a little dry. Then we've got a little smoky paprika. It doesn't matter whether it's the sweet or the smoky, really. Let's get that garlic in there. And then optional but recommended is some nutritional yeast. And that's it. Make sure you got enough juice to get everything mixed together. Ooh, yeah, don't forget that pepper, Reebs. Thank you. Get in some of that pepper. What's a winter loaf without some cracked pepper? And now give it a stir, add some water or veggie stock, and get everything together here. Now we're just gonna let it dry out. We wanna get as much of the liquid out as we can without it totally sticking, because we don't want any mush in our loaf. And if you have a lot of excess liquid in there, it's gonna be mushy. So just try to keep an eye on this. Let it keep moving it around so that all this water evaporates out, and then we'll be ready to go. Hope you didn't forget about your squash. We are ready to use it. Mine I just set aside. Throw it into a bowl. And now let's just mash it up a little. You don't need a potato masher or anything. Just grab a fork and just mash it up. Okay, this is now nice and mashy. It doesn't have to be perfect. We're gonna mix all this together, whatever. It doesn't have to be that exact, you know what I mean? And then let's take everything from our pan.
Wow, if all Santa brought me was this chestnut bake, I'd be a happy gal.
That's a lie. You want way more than just this chestnut loaf. I am on to you.
Yeah, I also want those scalloped potatoes.
These chestnuts are already in the bag, peeled, and ready to go. They do sell them in the bag, not peeled. I really recommend the peeled ones. Anyway, let's do it. I've got like a cup of them and I'm throwing them in the food processor. And then I've got some cashews. These are just raw cashews. And we're gonna pulse this. You don't wanna turn this into flour or a mush. You just wanna pulse it so we have some nice, nutty, coarse consistency in our loaf. You know what I'm saying? That is the consistency that I'm going for. A nice, coarse grind, but no big chunks, of anything. Oh my gosh, it smells so good. If you want to avoid the nuts, you could just take the cashews out and you could double your chestnuts maybe, because they do have a really nice rich flavor too. And that would save on a little bit of the added fat if you're trying to avoid that. Let's throw it into the bowl. We are close. You guessed it. Here's our flax egg. We're throwing that in. And then I've got just a little bit of chickpea flour just to hold everything together along with the flax egg. Now we're just going to mix it up and throw it in our loaf pan. Simple, simple. Get everything nice and combined. I've got a loaf pan here with just a little piece of parchment paper so that it doesn't stick in there too bad. And then we're going to throw it in. Simple, simple. Now, as you can see, obviously it is a bit on the moist side. So if you're trying to go for a more dried out loaf when it's all said and done and baked, you could let this sit overnight in the fridge. I don't have the patience for that. So this has been nice and flattened out on top, and we are throwing it into the oven. It is gonna take a bit of time in the oven. I'm gonna put this foil on top like that, and we're gonna put it in the oven for an hour at 350, and then we're gonna remove the foil and we're gonna do another 30 minutes. And that is my method. We'll see, I'll tell you at the end if it changes, but let's get it in there. So we did 60 minutes covered, and then I did another 30 minutes uncovered, and then I let it cool for like 20 minutes. And here is what we've got, and it looks very beautiful and loafy. It is not a really dense loaf. It's, you know, nice and soft. It's not mushy. All right, Reeves has taken her picture, so let's just get this back on the cutting board, you know what I mean? And take a little taste. So there's the inside. Check out the inside. Nice and beautiful. Lots of veggies in there. How good would this be with a little bit of my mushroom gravy on top? But let's just taste it by itself. So good. It's really savory. The richness from the nuts and the chestnuts, and then the veggies, the carrots, celery, onion. The mushroom is perfect. Last time I didn't do this with mushroom. I just added the mushroom and I love it. It's really good.
Well, at least I'm wearing a Christmas shirt, right? Oh, that's so good. I think I can taste the chestnuts, but there's so much flavor. So it's like a flavor burst.
Yeah.
And the butternut squash makes it like nice and creamy.
Y'all, you've got to try this loaf as part of your holiday feast, and be sure to check out all the other holiday recipe videos we put right here in this playlist for you. And also our January challenge is starting in January. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.